हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न चैप्टर 4 मैप्स पार्ट 1। इन दिस पार्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ मैप एंड इट्स मेन कंपोनेंट्स, डिस्टेंस व्हिच इज एक्सप्रेस्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ स्केल एंड डायरेक्शन।
अ मैप is a representation or drawing of the earth's surface or a part of it drawn on a flat surface according to a scale. What is important for a map? A scale is needed. Without a scale, a map can't be drawn. All we know, the shape of earth is sphere. It is not possible to flattened and spherical things. So when we draw a map on a flat surface, the shape of many features of the earth get distorted. So all these we will see. Maps are of three types: physical map, political maps, and thematic maps. Now see what are the differences between physical map, political maps and thematic maps. Physical maps are those maps which shows natural features of the earth like mountains, plateaus, plains, rivers, oceans, etc. So the maps showing natural features of the earth are called physical map or relief maps. Another map is called political maps. Some maps shows boundaries between countries, cities, towns, villages, countries of the world. So the map showing boundaries between these countries, cities, villages, states are called political map. Map which shows political boundaries called political maps. And third type of maps are called thematic maps, which shows distribution of some specific features like distribution of rainfall, distribution of forest, distribution of agricultural crops, distribution of industries. So these maps are called thematic maps. Now we will see what are the components of map. Maps are drawn, or to draw map, which components are needed? First is distance, second is direction, and third is symbol. Distance, direction and symbol. One by one we will see what are the uses of these on map and how do they help us in reading map. Distance. Maps are drawings which reduce the entire world or a part of it to fit on a sheet of paper. The size of earth is very large. The size of earth is very large or the sheet of paper is very small. So that large size is shown on a small sheet of paper. So you can understand how difficult is it. But these difficulties are removed by using scales. Scales. What is a scale? A scale is the ratio between the actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. It is a ratio between the actual ground distance as well as the distance shown on map. See the example. The distance between your school and your home is suppose 10 km. If you show this 10 km distance by 2 cm on a map, it means 1 centimeter on the map will show 5 kilometer on the ground. 5 kilometer of ground is shown in 1 centimeter on the map. So the scale of your drawing will be 1 centimeter is equal to 5 kilometer. Thus, scale is very important in any map. If you know the scale, you will be able to calculate the distance between any two places on a map. We will see more examples to understand how scale is useful on a map. When large areas like continents or countries are to be shown on paper, then we use a small scale. For example, 5 cm on the map shows 500 km of the ground. It is called a small scale map. When 1 cm represent more than 100 km area of ground, 1 cm on map represent more than 100 km area of ground, so that scale is called a small scale map. Or when a small area like your village, town is to be shown on paper, then we use a large scale, that is 5 cm on map shows 500 meters. Here 500 kilometer and here 500 meters only on the ground. And this scale is called large scale map. So small scale map represent large area and large scale map represent a small area. Must remember, large scale maps give more information than small scale maps. How? Because a large area is shown in very small area. It is not possible to explain in detail, show detailed feature of that area. But if a small area is represented in same sheet of paper, so all the features available in that area can be easily shown. So we can get detailed information through which scale map? Large scale maps. See this figure. It is a map of village. There are many features shown in this. It is drawn on which scale? Large scale. Large scale map, because small area are shown, are described on large scale map. See, 1 centimeter represent 10 meters. 5 centimeter represent 50 meter. See this map. In this area, at this corner, there is playground, tree, community center, post office, shops. Here are the houses of Vikas, Sheila and Kareem. Here is orchard. To this side, there is a school. Here is a well. This is road. Now, we will see the distance between post office and Kareem's house. If we measure the distance from here to here in a straight line, so it would be quite shortened, but it's not possible to walk straight on the earth's surface as it is not even. So we can walk comfortably by road, or there is too much turn on this road. Or if distance is measured between Kareem's house to post office, so it is about 12 centimeter from here to here. Again, from here to here, we can use a scale and measure it. This diagram is given, this picture is given in your book. So total length is 12 centimeter, means actual ground distance between Kareem's house and post office is of 12 into 5 meter means 60 meters. Second component of map is direction. Without the help of direction, we can't explain, can't read the map. As you have seen in many maps, N letter is marked to the right hand side at the top of the corner of the map, this side, to the top side. This is called north line, means top of the map show north direction. This diagram shows directions. Top shows north, bottom shows south. If you are facing towards it, to your right shows east direction and your left shows west direction. These four, north, south, east and west, are called cardinal directions, and between them there are intermediate directions. Between north and east there is northeast, between north and west there is northwest, between south and west there is southwest, between south and east there is southeast. So northwest, northeast, southwest, southeast, these are intermediate directions. See, in this diagram, in previous diagrams, what you saw here, this shows that this map, in this map, the top of this map is showing north direction. Automatically, if we get north direction, so easily we can find out the other directions. The bottom is, this bottom side is south, to right hand side it is east, and to the left of it is west. Now with the help of this, let you find out, and all of you see and find out the directions in relation to the features shown on this map. Kareem, in which direction school is from Kareem's house? So it is to this side. This side means between, not directly to the north, not directly to the east, means it lies between east and north, means northeast. School is to the northeast of Kareem or Sheila or Vikash house. In same way, community center. What is the location of community center from Vikash house? So it lies to the north, north of Vikash house, means Vikash house lies to the south of community center. So in this way, direction help us in reading map. So we already read which are the cardinal direction and which are intermediate directions. Magnetic compass is used to find out the direction. All you know, in earlier time, people found out the direction by using pole star. During daytime by seeing the position of sun, and at night by seeing the position of pole star. Pole star, which always remains above the north pole, called pole star. So with the help of these pole star and sun, people found out direction. But in cloudy weather it creates problem. So to know the direction during daytime, at night or in cloudy weather, this instrument is used, that is called magnetic compass. This will represent north direction always.
That's all in this part. Thank you.